Hello, I am David Grenache, an associate professor of pathology at the University of Utah School of Medicine and a medical director at ARUP Laboratories. I'd like to tell you about the clinical utility of testing for myelin basic protein. So let's start off by talking about myelin. It's a substance rich in lipids and proteins that forms layers around the axons of nerve fibers and functions as an insulator. It is essential for the proper functioning of nerves. The main function of a myelin layer, or a sheath, around axons is to increase the speed at which nerve impulses propagate along the myelinated fiber. Demyelination is the loss of the myelin sheath and is the hallmark of some neurodegenerative diseases such as multiple sclerosis. The exact etiology of MS is unknown, but a body of research supports the idea that it is an immunologically mediated disease. The diagnosis of MS requires the objective demonstration of disseminated central nervous system lesions in time and space. Because no single clinical feature or diagnostic test is sufficient for the diagnosis of MS, formal guidelines, known as the McDonald criteria, have been developed for the diagnosis of MS that integrates both clinical and imaging data. Importantly, the biochemical analysis of cerebrospinal fluid is no longer part of these criteria, but it does remain a component in the differential diagnosis. Biochemical analysis of cerebrospinal fluid provides evidence of the inflammatory response in the central nervous system. There are currently two well-established CSF biomarkers that are used to aid in the diagnosis of MS. One is the oligoclonal band test, and the other is the IgG index. Both of these tests measure the intrathecal production of IgG and provide a sensitive but non-specific indicator of CNS inflammation. Myelin basic protein, or MBP, is an important component of the myelin sheath. Because MBP concentrations rise in response to neuronal damage, it is, just like the oligoclonal band and IgG index test, considered to be a nonspecific marker of CNS inflammation. Although MBP was first proposed as a marker of MS more than 30 years ago, very few studies have evaluated its diagnostic accuracy. Notably, the studies that have evaluated MBP have shown wide variation in its diagnostic specificity, leading to considerable uncertainty regarding its use in the diagnosis of MS. Until recently, it was uncertain if MBP provided additional information that was unavailable from the well-characterized oligoclonal band and IgG index tests. As a large national referral laboratory, ARUP processes a high volume of tests for CNS inflammation, and we have observed that MBP is a frequently ordered test. This surprised us because of the lack of evidence that supports the utility of MBP and led us to suspect that MBP is a highly ordered but non-contributory test. To address this concern, we performed a study that sought to determine the clinical usefulness of MBP testing, and I'd like to share with you the results of that study. We evaluated the results of three tests, oligoclonal bands, IgG index, and MBP, performed on over 16,000 CSF samples sent to ARUP over a 22-month period. All included specimens were stratified into one of two groups, either an MS status known or an MS status unknown group. Medical chart review was used to determine the MS status in the MS status known group. Our results indicated that in both groups, IgG index and MBP were significantly associated with oligoclonal bands. However, the association of IgG index with oligoclonal bands was much stronger than the association of MBP with oligoclonal bands. The weak association between MBP and oligoclonal bands is likely due to the fact that MBP is relatively nonspecific, and there is a much greater tendency to have raised MBP in conditions that affect the CNS other than MS. When we evaluated the diagnostic performance of each test using the MS status known group, we observed that oligoclonal bands showed the strongest association with MS, followed by MBP and the IgG index. We also demonstrated that no test combination that included MBP had a diagnostic sensitivity or specificity that was statistically greater than any test combination that included oligoclonal bands and the IgG index alone. In other words, our study suggested that MBP provides no incremental diagnostic information relative to the other two tests. While our study was strengthened by the large sample size, there were some important limitations. First, we utilized medical chart review as the reference standard, which is imperfect because physicians often do not record the exact criteria used to make a diagnosis. Second, physicians were not blinded to the test results, which can introduce bias in the data analysis. Third, the number of samples in the MS known group was small. And fourth, this was an observational study, and the indication for performing the test was unknown. However, despite these limitations, we can conclude that the use of MBP for the diagnosis of MS is not currently supported by a strong base of evidence, and that MBP is a test with little clinical usefulness.